Who gon' stop me, huh? Who gon' stop me? Who gon' stop me, huh?
Black cars, black cars, black on black, black bras, whole lot of money in a black bag, black strap, you know what that's for.
Y'all weed purple, my money purple, y'all Steve Merkel, I'm Oprah Circle, yeah. I wrote the verse that I hope I heard you.
Go. Who gon' stop me, huh? Beat the odds, beat the fast, it wouldn't be wise, bet against the cat. Stop me, bro, I better get rich, night shift, 6 to 6, give me one shot, one pot. I show up in all white, wearing no socks, no ceiling, new coupe, they know I'm a dope boy, they don't have no proof.
Alright.
So Dom, how do you feel?
Good though, man.
Come on, Dom. Tell me what you think of your...
Yeah, what'd you think?
Yeah, what you think of your act, man?
I don't know. Started off kind of weird.
Let's think about this for a minute. No, let's not think about it. You ready to go up?
Alright, yeah.
You still want to go up?
Yeah, why not?
So, are you just going to stand up and come up here without me calling you? Do another 5. Let's do another 5 minutes. Get off the stage and I will bring you up appropriately. That's right.
Okay. Marcel, how did you think about it?
What?
It's all about dying.
Shit.
My life right there.
I don't know. I think I did about how I normal. Well, it is a little better.
I'm a little tired, so I'm going to do it like this for a bit, okay? You know, in hindsight, it probably wasn't a good idea sitting in the front row, being on the dick eye level of almost every comedian that's up here. And they're all talking about their dick or cock in some fashion. Except the nice white lady, she was very polite. She didn't dick once.
It was like a 0.2%.
Once they started talking about news, I was like, Marcel don't know shit about the news.
Yeah, I know. I was like, that's all I could think. I was like, Marcel don't know shit about Beyonce lip syncing because I was talking to him about it earlier. And he said, I don't care.
You seem like you're smart. Give me a subject to talk about freestyling or riffing. I don't like to say riffing, it sounds like masturbating.
Vaginal goo.
Vaginal goo? Come on, man. I don't feel talk about vaginal goo.
All right.
Come on, man.
Beyonce lip syncing.
What was up with that? Yeah. I watch the news. I mean, I read the news. I'm aware of the news. So, yeah, I also saw that Beyonce may have lip synced. Is it may or did? I see Beyonce and Jay-Z picture with Obama way too. How you gonna lip sync at your friends, the president's inauguration? That's not a good look. Especially when you're Beyonce, cause you're Beyonce. There's not much really else going on for black female singers. I mean, you could say Rihanna, but yeah, what else is in the news, you know? So. It's just like, if Beyonce goes down, what else do we have, you know? And that, I think, worries me the most about Beyonce lip syncing. Not that it could affect your career, but what's gonna happen to me? Beyonce lip syncing, Beyonce lip syncing. You know what? I don't care. Beyonce still looks good. I mean, that's why Jay-Z has sex with her. I'm pretty sure that's why. Yeah, because she looks good. I'll go with that. That's my own statement. Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, lip syncing, I think it's looking at it in a negative way. Maybe she wasn't lip syncing because she's lazy. Maybe she's lip syncing because she's pacing herself. Maybe she thought there was going to be an after party, and maybe there she was going to let loose, you know, a little dangerous in love. You got to build up stamina for something like that. Is it dangerous in love or crazy in love? I don't know. She's in love. That's what's important. In love with lip syncing. I said sinking, not singing. Alright. Singing. She likes to lip sing. Beyonce lip syncing. Beyonce lip syncing. Man, this is a small topic. Every news article is talking about this already. This is what you get me for my 5 minutes. That's okay.
Talk about Tim.
No! What did you say?
Manti.
I lie. I don't read or watch the news at all. I have no idea what you're talking about. It sounds bad interesting, though. What did you call it? What's it called?
Tailing.
What did
you call it?
Tailing. Yeah.
Yeah, what the hell is that? What is that?
I don't know. I mean, you know. I don't feel like explaining.
Well, then how am I going to explain it to everyone else?
Okay, talk about catfishing.
Catfishing? Like, yeah. Just fishing for cat.
Actually, I will say I did better, because I got a lot more props afterwards.
You did? I didn't get no props.
What?
I didn't get no props.
About? What guy said to you? The guy in the host.
Oh, I just asked him how I did. He was like, I was like, my first time. He was like, you did really good. I was like, okay. I just don't think I did that good.
All right. Moving right along. Let's give it up for Dominic Padgett.
Hello, everybody. Good evening. I'm Dominic. This is my first time doing stand-up. I'm from Marietta. I'm going to just look back in the light so I'm not looking at anybody. So y'all know I'm getting blinded right now. Got a pretty uneventful life. I mean, it's pretty eventful, but it's boring at the same time. I woke up today at about 3 o'clock. Made me a drink at about 3:20. I was felt like it was morning, so I made some coffee and put some rum in there, you know what I'm saying? So it was okay. When we got here, I don't know if anybody noticed this, but when the host came out, he said, about the drinks or whatever, the bartender said, what drinks do you like? I just said Jack and Coke, because I like Jack and Coke. I didn't know that she was actually going to bring me a Jack and Coke. So while all this was going on, I'm over here getting mad, and everybody's laughing and stuff, but personally, I'm like, damn, I'm broke. I hope she don't come back here with this drink, and then I gotta look embarrassed in front of everybody. I'm in the front row. Oh man, and lo and behold, she did. So before that, I'm over here telling her first, come on, man, I know y'all got this. I know y'all got $7, man. Our team just said $6. Probably ain't got no tip for it, man, damn. But yeah, that's how that went. Another thing, okay, so I was just, are there any weed smokers out there? You know what I'm saying? Just curious.
What?
Alright, that's what's up. A friend of weed is a friend indeed. Hello, friend. All right, so I'm gonna talk about the law right quick, because I recently got screwed over by the court system and whatnot, so I'm a little upset by that. I got it yesterday. So yeah, still a little shitty. So you know, I'm driving or whatever. I'm pretty buzzed. You know, I'm a little inebriated. Got a water pipe in the trunk or whatever. You know, just riding real dirty for no reason. Just don't know why I'm riding dirty like that. So yeah, as the cop pulls up behind me, and I'm just kind of, you know, just going, just driving. The cop pulls up behind me. I'm inebriated, got stuff in the back seat. I'm just nervous. I'm like, damn, I'm about to go to jail today. That's about to be my life. So he's behind me for about 6 miles or whatever, and then, you know, he's behind me. I'm like, okay, cool. So I smoke a celebratory cigarette. I'm like, man, he's behind me. Fuck you, cop. You know what I'm saying? I got music going. I get ignorant on the road. I'm over here just throwing my cigarette out the window, all that kind of stuff. And then comes time for me to finish my cigarette. And I'm, you know, hit that last hit of the cigarette. That's how you hit marijuana. So I do that and I flick it. Boom! I'm feeling good. Light turns green. I'm in the BMW. I'm pulling off. Woo! I was like, oh shit. I'm about to go to jail. Damn, man. Oh, fuck. Fucking beers on the side. Shit in the trunk. So he pulls me over. I got my gas. You know, I'm broke. You know, like I said with the joke in the first part, I'm broke because I don't know what, you know. So my gas light is on. You know about the riding on E life or whatever. So I'm out with the gas light on, me and there's just friends conversating and all that kind of stuff. And then I get pulled over, I'm waiting here, I'm like, oh man, this is gonna take long. Cause I'm like, either I'm gonna go to jail or I am going to get out of here, nothing going on. But I'm here for 2 hours now, cops haven't said anything. About 4 cops pull up, I'm like, damn, they're gonna take my black ass to jail. Here comes statistics. Okay, cool. I didn't know statistics, that's what's up. So then at a certain point my gas light is still on and only going now it's on the line. You know what I mean? You got the line thing goes a little bit underneath. That's where I'm at. I'm over here on the line. I still got 15 minutes to go there and back home. So I'm like, damn. So I'm over here. I see five cops over there. I put my hand on the window. Excuse me. Is anything? I need to know. Can you come here? What's up, Mr. Padgett? I need to know. Am I about to go to jail? My logic behind this and asking them this is because it's cold. It's getting dark outside. I'm small. I'm dark, I look okay, I don't want to go to jail at nighttime. That's not what I want to do. You know what I'm saying? I don't have much gas in the car, so I'm like, damn, it's cold as hell, I'm shitty, I'm upset, everybody's calling me, asking where I'm at. So I'm like, am I about to go to jail? He was like, well, no, sir. I was like, okay, so are we cool? He's like, yeah, you step out the car if you want to. Yeah, we're cool now. I was like, okay, cool, man. What's up? Yeah, I'm cool. I'm about to get off of here. I was like, so what are we waiting on? We were like, well, you know, we got these new printers now in our car, and so we can't write out tickets anymore. We have to use ink. And gosh darn it, I don't have any ink. So I was waiting on, I called Billy, and Billy came around the corner, and wouldn't you believe, Billy didn't have any ink either. So then we called Ralph, Mary, and Jane, and then they all came, and then they started talking and shit. And I was like, so who has ink? Oh, we just actually got it printed. I was like, oh man, come on, y'all wasting my gas and shit. Y'all can't even give me no ink to take home or anything like that. Bottom line, I got a ticket. A little fucking ticket at that, you know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, after when I was walking up, excuse me, when he was walking, he was like, I hope you have a better day than today. This is before Thanksgiving, asshole. Thanks, prick. I'm thankful for you. Or whatever. So anyway, so I was like, he's like, have a nice day. I said, well, my day is still pretty okay. And then he's like, why? I was like, just a good day. But when I got in the car, I was like, come on, pretty inebriated right now. I got a water pipe, being politically correct, in the back seat. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, a water pipe in the back seat, and I'm not in jail. That's what's up. Next thing I'll talk about, the Beyonce lip syncing or singing thing. I get a lot of things on my phone. I don't do Twitter because I'm socially awkward. I get a lot of things on my phone or whatever. And when that lip sync came, I don't know what time it said. I think it said three something. But when the lip syncing thing came up, I was like, oh man, the news just made that look terrible. They were like close family friends that no one ever said the Obamas said this, but they were like close friends of the Obamas, you know, that one friend. Who was like, oh hell no, who says everything that the Obamas want to say. You know what I'm saying? That the Obamas can't say. But it's like that auntie that's really close to everybody, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, Michelle Obama, someone said something about her outfit, that auntie come out of nowhere, y'all better stop, I picked it out of her myself, bitches. And Michelle Obama's kind of like, oh, it looks nice. You know what I'm saying? Hey, it's okay if you don't like what I'm wearing. It's all fine. I don't know what time it is, but I'm just improv up here for a little bit because people say I'm funny. One thing I like about, you know, making people, is that, are you being awkward? Okay, that was awkward, so I'm off the stage now? Alright, cool. I'm gonna just stare blankly into this so I heard it close my eyes. Alright, burns, I'm gonna go off the stage. Alright, so I'm Dominic Pazzi, everybody. Thank you.
Nobody listens to the rules. Dominic, good work. Give it up for Dominic one more time.
Should
you still recording?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, good.
Well, you did a lot of more so talking. Okay. It was good, though.
Because you're doing such a long story, you have a lot of punchlines, so your jokes are really spread out. But it was still good. I mean, it wasn't hilarious, but you know, hey. You know.
I'm saying, it wasn't no Celly Smalls.
Wasn't fishing for cat, huh?
I want to leave with this. Y'all been here for most of the show. There's nothing I could say, in my opinion, funnier than when that guy was up here earlier and he asked for a suggestion. Somebody yelled out, catfish? And he responded, you mean fishing for cats? I have no jokes better than that. That's as good as it will ever get in comedy. Fishing for cats was his go-to. That was magic.